Hello, this is a demonstration of how to use Claris FileMaker to connect to Google Drive to pass files back and forth. Using the example file that you see on my desktop, we are going to send a PDF up to Google and we're going to pull it back down. Instructions for downloading this demo file are included with the video, so please feel free to grab a copy. The first thing you're going to need to do is make sure that you have a free Google Developer account. I'm not going to walk you through that, so please go online and find the instructions and set one up. Once you have set up your account, we're going to need to define the project by going to the Google Developer Console. And what we'll do is we'll create a project. Give the project a name. And this takes a few seconds. Then once the project is created, we need to tell Google just what APIs we're going to be using. So we'll click on this Enable APIs and Services button. Search for Google Drive. And when it pops up, we'll enable it. With the API enabled, we need to create credentials now. So we make sure that we are explaining again Google Drive, and we'll select user data and then hit next. Again, we're going to set up a name. Does not have to be the same one. I'm just using it because I can. And we'll define our email for support and oops, let's not do that one. Set one up there too. Scopes are important, but they're not needed to just do the simple demo, so we're going to move on from that. And then for the Oauth client type, FileMaker is going to be doing insert from URLs, so we want to have a web application. And again, name filled in automatically, it's okay. Then at this point, we're going to end up having to insert the authorized redirect URL, which is just telling Google where to go if someone successfully logs in. It's really not that essential, but for the purposes of this demo, we're going to use the one that's supplied with our demo file. So we're going to reach over and grab that one real quick and paste it in. And that's this one. And at this point, we have a client ID and we've created our credentials, but we're not going to use them yet because there is another step you're going to have to do first. We want to come to the Oauth Consent screen. And we are going to make this external. Your choice is either to put it into testing and enter a email address of the person who's allowed to use it, or to put it straight into production. And for simplicity, we're going to go with production. Okay, now that we've got all that set up, we're going to step back to credentials really quick. And here is that client we set up. We're going to use the little pencil here under actions to get those details that we created earlier. starting with our client ID. We're going to paste that in right here. Then we're also going to grab our client secret and paste that in right here. So as you've seen, we've done this, we've done this, we've done this, we've done that, we've done that, we've done that, and all these things are ready to go. So let's go to the example. Okay. For this screen, everything you need to do comes down to the gold buttons on the left side of the screen. If you want to know what's going on in the background, you can see most of it right here in the behind the curtain section. The first thing we'll do is we're going to reach out to Google and we're going to request an access code. Google wants to make sure we're on the up and up, so it'll ask if it's okay. I'm going to use my account here. I'm going to allow it. And that redirect URL popped in back here. And that's all that is. That's all you needed to be concerned with on that. But now that we've got the code, and that is filled in right here, we can reach out and request access and refresh tokens. The access token is what you're going to use to actually talk to Google, and you'll see that in the scripts when you break them down to say, hey, I'm legit, let me in. It has a time limit on it, and so we also have a refresh token. And what happens with the refresh token is if you've gone for a certain amount of time, you can use the refresh token to request a new access token without having to go through everything we just went through to authorize and accept everything. So now we've got our two tokens, and this is where we're going to do the real lifting. We're going to start by uploading this file to Google. And you will notice down here, some things will be going on. If we went onto my Google Drive, did a refresh, there's the PDF that we just uploaded. So now that we've uploaded the PDF, the next step is to prove that it can come back. So by hitting the download file, we'll trigger a whole different script, which will reach out with that file ID that's listed there and bring the file back into a new container. And with that, you've just seen exactly how to upload and download a file into Google through FileMaker. Obviously, you're going to want to look at the scripts to see how it's all done, but now you know it's doable. And with that, we conclude this demonstration of using Claris FileMaker to move a file to Google Drive and to bring it back again. Please be aware that our scripts were constructed specifically to move a PDF file, and that we use just a few of the many options that are available in the Google Drive API. With a little bit of luck, you should be able to take what you've learned here and integrate it into your own projects. But if you get stuck or you're not a developer, please feel free to contact DB Services, and we would be glad to help. Thank you.